I don't really know who the leaders are. They're all dead. You know, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X. It's like you can't be a leader for the black community if you're alive. I mean, you probably wasn't doing your job.
Gun violence has taken the life of Los Angeles rapper Nipsey Hussle. Police say the 33-year-old was shot multiple times outside of his clothing store yesterday.
$1 billion ambition.
Running through this life like it was mine. Never settling, but setting every goal high. 1,000 burpees on the path to my own destruction or success. But what is a mistake without the lesson? See, the best teacher in life is your own experience. None of us know who we are until we fail. They say every man is defined by his reaction to any given situation. Well, who would you want to define you? Someone else or yourself?
But you're a celebrity.
Man, I'm a 60 crip, bro, first.
Okay.
All right, so learn about that, my nigga. Okay. Don't hey. Play with me.
Hey,
don't play with me.
So number one, the good part about gang culture, if you could even say that without being attacked, is that the world said we was wrong, but the set embraced you for who you was. You know what I mean? And that's the allure of gangbanging in the gang, is that you might have been broke, your mama might have been on drugs, you might have not had, you know, the material success, but the gang don't judge you on that. The gang judge you on your heart. You know what I'm saying? If you got heart, we gonna embrace you and we love you. And that's the only requirement. And so a lot of young people, that's all they had to offer. You know what I mean? They didn't have none of the qualities that made the world value you. You know what I mean? But the gang was pure in the sense that we were strictly off the heart. That's it. And it's considered violence because we're going to make you fight to show your heart. But if you show your heart, we're going to embrace you. And you're going to rise in the hierarchy. And you're going to be somebody, for better or for worse. That's the allure to a young kid. On the flip side, my generation grew up when technology became ubiquitous. I was in LA before it was cameras all over the place. I was in LA before they had cell phones that connected to all the towers. You know what I mean? And then that thing started happening. But the culture was, we was taught the game by older dudes that they gangbang when it wasn't cameras everywhere and it wasn't no technology. So they gave us a message in a book of rules that they was able to live by, but they didn't have technology working against them. So they misled us unintentionally, because when we start doing what they did to become reputable gang members, you know, ain't no way you gonna get away with it, bro. Ain't no way. Your phone is connected to the tower. And your big homie couldn't tell you nothing about that, because there wasn't no cell phones when they was out here going on missions. So when you didn't get caught with the gun and you made it back to the hood, but the police pulled up on you the next day and got your cell phone out your pocket, and you went to jail for life because that's the phone that was in the area of the murder when it took place. That's how you got caught. That's how you went down. And who's gonna give you that game? You had to learn from experience. So what happened was our generation started looking at the message we was getting like, wait a minute, bro. I know y'all intentions was good, but that don't work. The technology gonna whoop us. And that's what happened. We was victims of the whole, it ended street crime in LA for real, and it's ending it. So I was one of the people, I told my homies, we gotta embrace technology in a different way, because they're using it against us. I seen that. I remember we was at the Arco gas station on Crenshaw and Slauson, and some shit happened. I had one of my homies from Bounty Hunters was with me, and I was gonna pull into the gas station, and I seen about 35 of my homies out there, and I kept it pushing, because I didn't want to disrespect the night by bringing the blood into the hood with all the, wasn't nothing gonna happen to him. I just didn't feel like that energy.
Tension.
I didn't even feel like, you know, having to press no line or making my homies feel like I was disrespecting the hood, whatever. So I just kept it pushing, honked the horn, kept it pushing. So a shooting took place that night, you know, a big fight took place. And a week later, I remember my grandma telling me, was you at the gas station that night? No, I wasn't at the gas station. All right, I was at the block club. The police said they got everything on tape. Oh yeah, damn. A week later, the whole hood got raided. And 15, 16 people ended up getting real time. 55 years with an L behind that. And that was my eye opener. I'm like, they got it, it's over. They won. The technology ended this, because that was regular gangbanging. That would happen every night. Man, just shoot out the gas station. Out of it, not at it. Sometimes at it too, but every night. And I just said that to say, the second thing, we got trained from a generation that didn't have the same elements working against them. Even the laws was different. They got a thing called a gang enhancement. Meaning, let's say, bro, you a gang member. I don't gang bang. You know, you and Rosenberg see me, bow. y'all jump me. Regular gang, y'all fight me. Y'all break my nose. All right, that's a fight. Now, the fight hold maybe 16 months to 3 years max, depending on y'all criminal history. But you got the hood tattooed on you. He don't. He gonna get his 3 years. You got rolling 60s tattooed on your body. Now, when you go to court, they gonna say, all right, you giving you 3 years for the actual crime, but your gang enhancement holds 30. Because now they saying you done this for the benefit of a hood that has a history of murder, killing, bank robbery. So you doing this to benefit this hood. So now your crime gonna get you 3. Your gang enhancement, just cause your tattoo, gonna get you 30. He got 3 years, you got 33 years. That's how they start whooping people. It's called a gang enhancement. And it's unbelievable. A carjacking gets you life if you from a gang. The gang enhancement on carjacking is life. You take somebody's car. And a lot of people fell victim to that in our generation. That was a new law. So that's the second part of the answer. And the third part, I kind of lost track of the of where we was going. But it was a long subject. I come back to it when I think about it. But, you know, it's tricky. But at the end of the day, this generation calls for a different protocol.
You know, I think that part of our culture that prevents us is we think, like, being smart is not cool. Or we think like being intelligent or speaking intelligent is not hood, or it's not like, you're not a man. That's out, man. That's why I celebrate Idris, because, you know, his confidence to be himself and to carry his truth is valuable and it's inspiring. I think we should all take a page from that, because,
Baby Gooch, RSC, AKA Young Gucciavelli, man. We're at ground zero where it all started, bro.
Come on, Pharaoh, let's get it. Huh?
Oh, what?
Hey.
Classic Nas. All Nipsey right. Hussle. Come on, Vegas.
Turn that beat up a little bit for me.
Turn that up.
Yeah. Hustle's like. Hustle's like. Yeah. Vegas, what up? Look. Look, I never take a break. Even when I'm hoarse, I was married to the streets and footers. I got divorced, so I just go hard and let nature take its course. And cinematic records is the label I extort. No, see, that's a cheap shot to John Shipes. Most of these rappers now is no bars and all hype. Look what I'm backing out, this your car have four pipes and bulletproof windows. Mess around, save your life. They say, hustle, you're the greatest, I say, you're right. I'm more confident than a short mic. I'm Ali, Gretzky, or Mike. But it's still RSC for life.
And this is the history of series.
How did you get the name Nipsey? What was that all about?
One day we was in here, we knew, you know, it was getting kind of hectic because we was making a lot of songs. So we knew we was finna start embarking on something. So he's like, I got to put a stamp on my name. I just can't go by my government. Just can't go by E. So I was like, all right, I got you, man. We're going to just put it in the air. We're going to sit back and let it come. And then one day it just came to me, Nipsey Hussle. I don't know how it came. It just like a light bulb popped off. I was like, yeah, that's it. I knew when I first came to it, I was like, that's the name for you. So I told him, Nipsey Hussle, man, Tony by the spelling. He was like, where'd you get that from? I was like, it just came to me. But, you know, it's an old cat named Nipsey Russell, who was actually a Tin Man in the Black Wizard of Oz. He was like a black activist to me, and he used to, you know, do a lot of rhyming and scatting and talking. So I was like, that'll fit right there. He was like an activist in the 70s doing his thing, and it just clicked, you know what I mean?
Did you hear that Nipsey Hussle wanted to do a documentary about Nas's I Am album?
No, I didn't. I didn't hear about that.
Everybody's looking for something. Just some thoughts for the mind. I take a glimpse into time. Watch the blimp read the world is mine.
Imagine that. Yo, Jungle, how you feel about that Nas shit?
Niggas heard that shit, man. The fuck is that, man?
Set it off, broken glass in the hallway, bloodstained floors, neighbors, look at every bag you bring through your doors, lock the top lock, mama should have cuffed me to the radiator, why not, it might have saved me later from my block and why cops, hookers crawling off the stroke.
An additional fact is that that same photographer would elaborate how the I Am album art was intended to build on the theme from the covers of Nas's previous efforts, Illmatic and It Was Written. The first one, you have Nas pictured to be a little boy. The second was Nas to be older. And the third, he was a king. He was on top of the world.
To me, when he first started rapping, you know, I told him, I was like, man, you remind me of Nas.
Sometimes I jump the bus just to get away, escape this ghetto estate, the one away line to find a brighter day, cause my life is great, plus this heavy cloud is looming, and my future's dooming, black's the only color that the beast consuming, and at the stop, I check my nigga Dave lifting, yo, his legs twitching, couple teeth missing, and instead of sickening, he gave me dapped in, his skin so thin, I peeped the ash cover tracks where his syringes went in, he coughed twice before he spoke, I pat his back for breath, he punched it off, punched his chest, and his statements begin, he's like, yo, you know your nigga's good for alone, I need a nickel stone. Without the hard white, can't make it through the night though. I'm at rehab, about the free clinic. My system got my vein itching, hit you back 5 placentas. Now I'm tripping. I knew this bass head before his addiction, just another victim of the system's prescription for niggas. Still had to stop waiting. I check my sweat pockets for change. He's rubbing his palms together, keeps repeating his phrase. I'm like, yo.
You know what I mean? You got a nice spirit and you sharp.
Right out the gate, you give him Nas,
bruh. Right out the gate, I was like, Nas. He didn't have that Snoop persona like people say. It's a freestyle we got. It got a couple of freestyles. I got to get it from Dexter. When you see Nip rapping like 13, you like, all right, yeah, that's that. I can see where you get that analogy from Nas.
Tupac of my generation. Young black nigga trapped and he can't change it. Know he a genius, he just can't claim it. Because they left him no platforms to explain it. He frustrated, so he get faded. But deep down inside, he know you can't fade him.
When did you cross over to the turf? What made you do that? What was all that about?
Shit, really, cuz I was out here since I was like 15, you know what I'm saying? I got put out the house when I was 15. A nigga was with me since that age. A nigga was home one. But a nigga officially started banging up when I was like 17, 18. But, I mean, shit, a nigga was already out here. I was getting money in the hood, you know what I'm saying? I was functioning with the homies. I grew up in this neighborhood since day one. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? Everything that came with being from the hood, I was already exposed to. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't f***ing with no snakes. There ain't nothing charming about no snake. I don't trust a snake. I don't care how well you say you got it trained. It just ain't chose to turn on you yet. That's all that you showing me. He ain't chose to bite your yet. Anybody know got a snake? They got bit by that snake. I ain't f***ing with it.